Jeremiah chapter 18. book of the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 18.
I don't preach because I just want to preach.
I know that's right.
But I preach because, honestly, I can't help myself. Are y'all gonna walk here with me? And I can't help myself because I've been taught. Yeah, while I was yet in my mother's womb, God chose me. Are y'all gonna walk here with me? And every now and then you hear about someone who has become addicted. And addiction is really not a bad word. It is just falling on hard times. Because usually when you hear someone being addicted, they are addicted to alcohol, and they're addicted to crack cocaine, and they're addicted to drugs and this, that, and the other. But my brothers and my sisters, I'm not addicted to alcohol, and I'm not addicted to drugs, but I'm addicted to what I'm doing.
All right.
I'm addicted to preaching the gospel. I'm addicted to telling men, women, boys, and girls that there is a reality in serving a true and living God.
All right.
I'm addicted to telling somebody that if you just hold on just a little while longer, weeping may endure for a nighttime, but joy is going to come in the morning. I'm addicted to telling somebody that's going through the storm and through the rain that God hears you when you cry. And the God that I serve will supply all of your needs. And so I'm not addicted to some of those other things, but I'm addicted to preaching the gospel of Jesus the Christ. Well, the call came from God. And we now hear Jeremiah saying, I cannot speak, for I am but a child. And the Lord said unto him, don't you tell me about you being a child. You just do what I tell you to do. You just say what I tell you to say. And you go where I tell you to go. And here in this 18th chapter, the word of the Lord comes to Jeremiah. Get up and go down to the potter's house. Now it appears to me that Jeremiah the prophet, he already knew where the potter's house was. And he knew where to find it. He goes there not to preach a sermon. He goes there but to prepare a sermon. He goes to the potter house. And the Bible says he's supposed to watch how the potter manages his work. And there I will cause thee to hear my words. My brothers and my sisters, there's something to be said about that. You don't always have to be the one on the program. You don't always have to be the one getting your name called. You ought to get somewhere and watch and wait and let the Lord speak to you. Ain't God all right? And if you watch and if you wait, just might hear from the Lord. The prophet was never disobedient to the voice of the Lord. He went to the potter's house, and the potter kept on working. He watched the potter work on the wheels, and when a lump came in the clay, the potter who designed it, he took it and he had to make it over again. Sometimes the clay got too stiff. And so he had to make it over again. And you know, people are like that in church. Yeah, they get a little stiff in church. Yeah, the Bible says into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. But we come into the house of the Lord and we get stiff. And we wonder why the Lord has to break us and make us over again. Yeah, we get some bumps and bruises and we refuse to give our very best. But my brother and my sister, I want to tell you, if you mourn and you're in his hand, the potter has enough of what it takes to turn it all the way around. Ain't God all right? And that brings me to the crux of our discussion for tonight. Unsatisfied with the clay in his hands, the potter made it over again. Yeah, Lord, make me over again. Yeah, and I think it's wise for us to understand, number one, the sovereignty of God. For we cannot, I cannot do what I want to do when I'm in his hands. Yeah, can I do with you this potter as it did with the clay? Because I'm in his hands. You see, I may have some lumps. I may have some things that are unfortunate about me. I may have some ups and downs in life. But as long as I'm in his hands, yeah, everything is going to be all right. Oh, my brothers and my sisters, your life is not your own. And what we think we own, we do not. You don't own anything because it all belongs to God. You don't own the land because the book says that the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. And you don't own the money because the Bible says that the silver is mine and the gold is mine, saith the Lord of hosts. And you don't own yourself because you've been bought with the price. So glorify the Lord with your body and in your spirit, which all belongs to him. Now, the thing that gets my wheels turning in, when I think about it, who is the one that messed up? For you see, the potter had his hands on it, but the clay got marred. Who is the one that messed up? Yeah, where was the problem found? Was the problem in the clay? Or was the problem in the hand of the potter? Well, my brother and my sister, yeah, let's not keep you too long. I think I need to tell us that the potter hand is all right. And you and I have the problem. Yeah, you and I are the ones that fall short. You and I are the ones that mess up. You and I are the ones that drop the ball. You and I are the ones that go astray. And Brother Martin, I'm trying to tell all are, let the potter put us back together again. The problem is not with the potter, but the problem is with the clay.
Right.
I feel like preaching in here. You see, my brother and my sister, you and I are flawed. You and I are messed up. We were born in sin, shaped in iniquity. You and I are flawed and messed up. Yeah, how do I know this? If you catch a little baby doing something that they don't have any business doing, and you ask them, what are you doing? They put their hands behind their back and shake their head and say nothing. I'm trying to tell us, you and I are all flawed and messed up. Ain't gone all right. But I'm so glad that the potter didn't throw us away, but he wants to put us back together again. Yes, Lord, and I things are in my life that I wouldn't tell my mother about. But praise be to God, He loved me anyhow. And although He knows all about me, He still loved me. HGTV channel. Yeah, that's the makeover channel. And there's a show that's on HGTV. And they call it Fixer Upper. Yeah, now Fixer Upper, they find a house. They say it's a good house, or rather a bad neighborhood. But a good house, or a good neighborhood, and a bad house. Inside, and they walk around, and when they get inside, there's holes in the wall. When they get inside, there's rat droppings everywhere. When they get inside, the floor is no good. When they get inside, there's holes in the roof, and they say, well, this looks real bad. But I hear the interior designer, so you looking at how it looks now, but let me put a new roof on it. Let me put some new carpet down. Let me put some paint on the wall. Come back in a little while and let's see how it may go. I'm so glad when I was messed up. I'm so get your own.